Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel and to another part of the series about Illustrator's image trays. And in this edition, we're going to take a look at very detailed black and white images. So this is a scan of the Four Horsemen by Albrecht Dürer. I have taken it from the Wikipedia and I have made three versions of it. Or rather, this one is the original. It's an RGB image. And you see, we can get a glimpse of the paper this has been printed on. And the other ones are edited. So I've taken Photoshop and cleaned it up. This one is a grayscale image. And this one is a black and white image. So it's a bitmap in the sense of a black and white image. These kind of images are often made in black and white as bitmaps. And in the current version of Illustrator, this is not a big deal. Illustrator gives us rather good results with black and white images. But if you are using version CS6 or anything slightly higher than that, then actually having a grayscale image is the better option. So let's take a look at the original first, and I'm going to select it, and then let's go to the image trace panel and let's just hit the black and white button. We get the warning because this image is huge. But still, Illustrator does a pretty good job and we will get a fast result. So here it is. And just to give you an idea of how large this is, this one is the artboard in A4. So here's the result. And of course, this already looks not so bad, but the dark areas don't have a lot of detail. So let's turn on the original and you see this is not really good. So what can we do? Of course, the preset will not give us the best results, so let's do the obvious and let's move the noise slider to the left so we get more noise. We get smaller areas, but still nothing in here. So let's move the detail to high and just get a more precise result. And you see, this is very precise. When doing this very precise trace, Illustrator tries to give us every single pixel. And of course, we do not want that. So let's make that slightly lower. Let's get this to 95 and then we will get nicer curves like this, but still no detail in here. And to get that, we actually need to move the threshold slider, but we need to move it to the left to get the lighter image in order to get more detail in here. And you see there is the detail, but it comes at a cost. So this one here gets thinner as well, and that's not good. And of course, in the lighter areas in here, that's not the best result. So let's go to the grayscale image. And since Illustrator does not need to do that much, we might get better results here. And let's go in there and have Illustrator trace it. And again, noise to the left. And detail to the right, but not to the far right. So, and we get more detail. And also, we do not need to move this slider a lot to already get something in there. So, like this. This is already better. And as I said, there will not be a lot of difference when doing this one. So I'm going to leave it at that. And we can take a look at something that is really weird. So let's make a duplicate of this grayscale, and I'm going to release the image trace, and what we will now do is crop that image. So basically it will get smaller. And let's make it smaller here and there as well. And then here and from the top like this. So this is a smaller image, but is still large enough to present us with this warning. And what you can already see when we have the smaller image, we get a better representation without even having to move this slider. So what we learn from this? Illustrator works better with smaller image. We get more detail. Of course, this might not be a solution to your problem, because if you have to trace that large image, then later on you would have to piece the results together, and then you might run into issues again. But maybe this is something that is actually a solution for your drawing, because it's possible to trace it in pieces and then you can do it like that. It's just something I wanted to show you because it's very, very interesting.